So after solving these two exemplar problems, children, the last topic what you have is this practical applications of heating effect of electric current. This we have already discussed under this concept heating effect of electric current only. Various appliances which consumes the current or the electricity. So part of the energy is dissipated in the form of heat energy, and that is called heating effect of electric current, which we have already studied. So let us study. Just glance through it fast once again. So here what I felt important only, that part I will tell you. However, see in this first paragraph under this heading, however, the heating effect of electric current has many useful applications. The electric laundry, iron, electric toaster, electric oven, electric kettle and electric heater are some of the familiar devices based on this Joule's heating. So they may ask you what are the which are the appliances which work on this Joule's law of heating, then you can tell, no, this electric oven, electric heater, electric iron, all these are the appliances which works on this what heating effect of electric current or the Joule's law of heating principle. The electric heating is also used to produce light. How? I said, you know, by drawing an electric circuit, if at all in place of conductor you connect a bulb, what happens? The current, the electrical energy is converted to light energy. And then the bulb gets heated up, which in turn is the light energy is converted into heat energy. That is what they are explaining here. See, the electric heating is also produced to light as in an electric bulb. Yet the filament must retain as much as of the heat generated as is possible so that it gets very hot and emits light. It must not melt at high temperature. So what happens? When continuously, see, it is not like you switch on, the bulb will go, so enough current, it will store some charge or current so that I can switch off. No, that is different. Chargeable bulbs also you have these days. The emergency lights what you use, no? So if at all you charge it, the charge, those are capacitors, children, you will study in the higher class. Capacitor, just like the resistor or the bulb or whatever it is, capacitor is also a device which is connected in the circuit. It will store the what charges in it, and when you charge the power banks, best example for this usage of this capacitor is the power banks. Yes, now what you do, you charge the power banks, of course. So the charges what you give to the power bank, it will be stored. Yes, now hence it is called power bank. Have you ever thought why the name power bank is given? You know the what is bank, where we save money, like in this form of money in the bank. Here the power means what, the charge is been stored here. So that is called power bank. So something should be there, no? What should be there to hold? So if I want to hold water, then I need one tumbler at least. So like that, in the power banks or such similar devices, you have something called a device called the capacitor. So it is also small component just like the resistor. So what happens is this capacitors will hold the charge. It has a capacity to store the charges in it, and whenever you switch on or whenever you are using it, it will work the component. It helps in working the component by spending the stored charges. Best example is power management. So that is about the capacitors. Like that only, in case of electric bulb, continuously the current is flowing through the bulb, and hence it will store lot of current within it. So hence the temperature of the bulb goes on increasing. So as the temperature there goes on increasing, the bulb, the glass part that should not break off, no? So what is happening is, it must not melt. What? The tungsten, you all know it is made up of tungsten. That is what they are given here. The filament must retain as much of heat energy generated as is possible, so that it gets very hot and emits light. The tungsten, so it will store the light or the current what you are supplying, it will store it, it will get heated up, and then it will light up. It will help the bulb in glowing, children. So heats as is possible so that it gets very hot and emits light. It must not melt at such high temperature. What is the use if it melts? If it is not able to withstand that high temperature and help in glowing of the light, then it should be able to withstand that high temperature. That is very important. So a strong metal with high melting point such as tungsten. See, its melting point they are given in the bracket, children. It is 3380 degrees Celsius is the melting point of tungsten can withstand that high heat, temperature or heat, what we understand by this. So that is, tungsten is being used for making the bulbs in the filaments. It means filaments in the bulbs. It is tungsten wire. The filament should be thermally isolated as much as possible using insulating support, etc. The bulbs are usually filled with chemically inactive nitrogen and argon gases to prolong the life of the filament. Yes, no? Since the current will be there, the chemical reaction may take place inside the bulb. So, non-reacting or non-chemical reacting substances or gases such as nitrogen, inactive nitrogen and argon gases are used inside the bulb so that the tungsten or the filament doesn't get reacted with it. Most of the power consumed by the filament appears as heat and a small part of it is used in the form to light, the light in the form of light radiated. So most of the energy here is spent in the heating the bulb, and some part of energy is used only to glow the bulb or radiate the bulb. Another common application of this Joule's law is the fuse used in the circuit. So you all have heard of this fuse. Yes, no? You, if at all the power is there in the whole lane of yours, but in your house, what is it? First, what you do? You go check the fuse whether there is any mistake. So what is this fuse? It is a device which is always connected in series and with any device. Its work is to avoid a rushing of high voltage, maybe due to lightning or thunder, the sudden lightning. So the fuse will stop, it will save all the appliances in your home. So this fuse is a must. It is used, you can see the in your electric circuit, the electric meter near your house, children, you can see the fuse. Please go save it. Another common application of Joule's law of heating is a fuse used in the electrical circuit. It protects the circuits and appliances by stopping the flow of any unduly high electric current. The fuse is placed in series with the device. This is important. What it consists of means it consists of a piece of wire which is made up of a metal or an alloy of appropriate melting point. For example, aluminium, copper, iron, lead, etc. So these are the materials which is used in making the wire in case of the fuse. It consists of a piece of wire made up of, if a current larger than the specified value flows through the circuit, the temperature of the fuse wire increases. This melts the fuse wire and breaks the circuit. This is very, very important, children. So how does the fuse work, if they ask you? What happens? The fuse wire, fuse is the device which stops the unduly high high voltage or current flowing to the appliances and protects it from damaging. One point, fuse is a device which is always connected in series. Second point, it consists of a wire in it which is made up of materials with copper, lead, iron, etc. with some appropriate, its own melting points, because each wire has its own melting point. And how it works, how does the fuse work means, if a current larger than specified value flow through the circuit, the temperature of the fuse wire increases. Just now we discussed what the wire of the fuse may be made up of, copper, iron or aluminium, etc. So when high current, for example, you might have seen 2 voltage bulb, 5 watts bulb, 2 watts bulb, like that you use 60 watts bulb, like the different power bulb, watts bulb you use in your houses. So like that, if more than that power or current flows through that appliance, then obviously it will damage the appliance. So when the fuse is connected, what happens is, whenever there is current which is more than required amount, then the fuse wire will melt and break the circuit, and hence it will avoid the further flow of current into the appliance. So this is the appliance, this is the fuse. So this is fuse, this is appliance. Okay, why? Because current should flow through the fuse to the appliance. No? So this is fuse, this is appliance. Now, suppose this is the electric bulb. This requires only some 2 ampere of current, you say. So now I will connect one fuse to in series with the bulb now. So what happens? Suddenly the current is coming, which is 5 ampere. The current of 5 ampere is being passing through. So what will happen, this alloy which consists of wire, so if 5 ampere current flows into the bulb which requires only 2 ampere of current, obviously this bulb will get damaged. Yes, no? So what is this fuse doing? When that high current comes, So it will be knowing how much current the device connected is requiring. So if high current unduly if it comes, what it will have do is the wire which is present in the fuse, children, it will store the energy so that it will melt. That high temperature, it will melt. The fuse wire itself will melt and breaks the circuit. Means it is breaking the circuit, means it is not allowing for the current to flow through the bulb. So the bulbs remain safe and the circuit is broken down by this fuse wire, which is melting itself and breaking the circuit. This is the why the fuse is very much required for any appliance and it is always connected in series, children. See here, this line you underline in your textbook. If a current larger than the specified value flows through the circuit, the temperature of the fuse wire increases. This melts the fuse wire and breaks the circuit. The fuse wire is usually encased in a cartridge of porcelain or similar material with metal ends. The fuses used for domestic purpose are rated as 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 3 ampere, 5 ampere, 10 ampere, etc. For an electric iron, so fuses means for each device or each appliance requires different amount of current for its working, children. So that how much ever the bulb requires the current, that many ampere related fuse only you can connect. That is what they are. The fuses used for domestic purposes are rated as 1 ampere, 2 ampere, 5 ampere, 10 ampere, etc. Now to understand that, they have given an example here. For an electric iron, for an iron box which consumes 1 kilowatt electric power when operated at 220 volt source, a current of 1000 divided by 220 ampere, that is 4.54 ampere. What are they doing here is, so what are they doing here is, so just now we learned the fuse of different amperes as the appliance requires, based on our requirement we can use that many ampere of fuse. They have given here an example of an electric iron box. So it consumes 1 kilowatt, means 1 kilowatt is the power, P is 1 kilowatt. So you know now, children, kilo means 1000, so it is 1000 watts. 1 kilowatt means 1000 watts. Next part you will study this kilowatt hour and all. So for an electric iron which consumes 1 kilowatt electric power when operated at 220 volts source, a current of, so P is equal to, it is product of V into II, we know. So power value we know, 1000 watts is the power at which the iron box works, and when the what, how much voltage is supplied, to 220 volts voltage is supplied, means how much current, how many ampere fuse need to be connected with that, means how do you calculate, I is P divided by V. This is the formula which we solved problem previously. I is P by V means they are doing this, that is 1000 divided by 220, 0 0 gets cancelled, 2 ones are 2, 1s are 2, 5s are 0. 50 divided by 11 means current is 4 point something, you will get 4.54 ampere it seems. So 4.54 ampere. So when iron with power of 1000, 1 kilowatt or 1000 watts, kilo means 1000, you know, no? So 1 kilowatt means 1000 watts it is. It is connected to a voltage of a source of 220 volts. How much current it is using, means I is 4.54, that is 4.54 ampere will flow in the circuit. In this case, 5 ampere fuse must be used. So you cannot exactly use 4.54 ampere, no? 4.54 means it is approximately 5 ampere. If you use 4 ampere fuse, then it is very much less. So 6 ampere is what? So as it is required, 5 ampere or 4.54 we got the current. Hence nearest, if you round it off, 4.54 is almost 5 ampere. So 5 ampere fuse need to be connected for an iron box. Like this, children, for each appliances if you want, it has its own value of it. It draws different value of current, and hence how many amperes of this fuse wire is required or fuse is required. In this case, 5 ampere fuse must be applied. So in that each case, or in each case of each appliance, you can find it out. So these are about the practical applications of heating effect. So here what you need to keep in mind is, after knowing what is heating effect of electric current, Joule's law of heating, and you solve problems as well. Next, under practical applications of heating effect, children, one thing is we studied different devices or appliances which works under this Joule's law of heating or heating effect of electric current, maybe like the electric iron box, electric heater, toaster, all such things, electric oven also you can tell. That you should keep in mind. They may ask you which are the devices which works on this principle of heating effect of electric current or Joule's law of heating. Either way they can ask you. So your answer should be these appliances. And they explained about the working of this electric bulb, which consists of the tungsten wire inside, which when current is passed through the bulb, it stores the current, it gets heated up and finally lights. The light is radiated from the bulb. So this it is made up of the wire, the tungsten. It has very melting point. How much melting point? Very high melting point of 3380 degrees Celsius of melting point it has. So it can withstand very high temperature. So tungsten is used, and what is filled inside the bulb? Argon and the nitrogen gas has been filled inside the bulb. Why? Because those are the non-reactive gases, means it does not interact and chemical reaction should not take place inside the bulb. Hence this argon or nitrogen gas has been used inside the bulb, and the filament used is the tungsten. That's the thing you should keep in mind. Another one more application is about the fuse. What is a fuse? It is a device which stops the unduly flowing current into any appliances and protects it from damaging. Fuse is always connected in series. And fuse, for the domestic purpose, what are the values of different fuse current means for 2 ampere, 3 ampere, 5 ampere, like that. They consider the example of electric iron box, which consumes the power of 1000 watts, that is 1 kilowatt. And the voltage supplied was 220 volts. So when we find it out, we came to know a current flowing through is 5 ampere of current is flowing through that circuit. Means fuse which is with capacity of 5 ampere need to be connected in series with the iron box in order to protect it from unduly flow of current. This is the work of the fuse, children. So this is about the practical application of electric current. Next, you have the concept of electric power, which we already know. Just you need to remember this formula, P is equal to V into I. Power is the product of voltage into current, and its unit is watt. So we shall soon glance into. You have studied in your earlier class, the rate of doing work is power. This is also the rate of consumption of energy. So equation 12.21, we had it here, 12.21, that is H is equal to I square RT, the Joule's law formula, what we have that equation, gives the rate at which the electric energy is dissipated or consumed in an electric circuit. Dissipated means, I am telling you again, energy getting converted from one form to another is dissipation. This is also termed as electric power. So, why, children? Because we learned now under heating effect that some part of the energy is getting converted into heat energy. So, that this is also termed as the electric power, they are telling. So, P is equal to V into I. Next step, what they have done is, in place of V, using Ohm's law, they have substituted V is equal to I into R by using Ohm's law. Formula which you need to remember in case of this power is P is equal to I into V. Next step, what they have done is V into I. Okay, no problem. I keeping as it is, V is equal to I into R by using Ohm's law. Alva, that they have substituted I into I, I square. P is equal to I square into R is also one of the formula in order to find the power. Or I is V by R also they have substituted. That's a unit is watt. So V square by R. One, two, and three doubles you have. See, three formulas you need to keep in mind. When to use which? it is based on the given question, children. If two unknown quantities may be current, voltage in terms it is given, then you can directly go for this formula. If resistance and current is given, if current power is asked, then don't sit and think, oh, voltage is not given, how to find out power? No, then you can use of this formula, which is by Ohm's law. Usually these two formulas only they ask, don't worry much about this. So P is equal to I into V or V into I, since it is product, you can write it either way. And P is equal to I square into R are the two formulas which we learned in order to find the electric power. The SI unit of electric power is watt, and in bracket they have given capital letter W, which means it is its unit. That is how you represent. It is the power consumed by a device that carries 1 ampere of current when operated at a potential difference of 1 volt. How do you define the unit of electric power, that is watt? Is 1 watt is 1 volt into 1 ampere. It is clear. P is equal to V into IV now. So it is voltage means 1 volt, current means 1 ampere. 1 voltage into 1 ampere gives you power, which is 1 watt. That is what they are given here. So 1 volt ampere is nothing but 1 watt. The unit watt is very small. Therefore, in actual practice, we use a much larger unit called kilowatt. We already studied, no, here, oh, I raised the problem. Kilowatt, here in the example of iron box, children, we studied, no, kilowatt. It is equal to 1000 watts. We substituted. Kilo means 1000. So, 1 kilowatt means 1000 watts it is. Since 2 kilowatt means 2 into 1000, 2000 watts. 10 kilowatts means 10 into 1000, 10,000 watt hour, watts, like that. Since the electric energy is is a product of power and time, the unit of energy is therefore watt hour. This is very important. See, electrical energy is the product of power and time. I is P into T, children. Electric current is the product of electric power into time. So unit of power is watt, and SI unit or hours, if you take watt hour, you got. So current is, you can also measure current in terms of watt hour, or if it is, since watt is very small quantity, as they said, kilowatt is being used. So KWH, kilowatt hour. If you observe the electric meter of your house, children, KWH will be written. What does it mean? Kilowatt hour. Kilo means 1000. Watt is a unit of power, electric power, and H is the hour, unit of time. So how many kilowatt per hour has been written there? You can check in the meter box in your house. So watt hour, therefore watt hour. 1 watt hour is the energy consumed when 1 watt of power is used for 1 hour. The commercial unit of electric energy is kilowatt hour, commonly known as unit. You can observe kilowatt hour. Here they said, no, 1 watt hour means how much it is the energy dissipated. See, if at all they ask you such questions, children, just write the mathematical form of it. Formula you write. So here the question is, 1 watt hour is what? 1 watt hour is what? Means it is simply the energy consumed. 1 watt hour. 1 watt hour is energy consumed when 1 watt of power is used for 1 hour. When 1 watt is used for 1 hour, then it is called 1 watt hour. That is the power, energy consumed. So the commercial unit of energy is kilowatt hour. Now, so if you measure the terms, even in this electric meter, as I said, if you observe kilowatt, they measure the current in the bill and all, you can observe it is measured in terms of kilowatt hour. This is a commercial unit used everywhere. They measure the current in terms of kilowatt hour, that is a power. So they have given you here in the next blue color what you see, children. 1 kilowatt hour is, kilo means 1000, hour means 3600 seconds per hour. So this is I will show it to you on the board. 1 kilowatt hour. Kilo means what? 1000. Hour means 1 hour is how many seconds? 3600 seconds. If you multiply, 36 into 1 is 36, followed by 3 plus 2, 5 zeros. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 zeros. So it is 36 into 10 to the power 1, 2, 3, 4, five zeros, or they have kept it in terms of 10 to the power 6. So, means 36, 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joule. 1 kilowatt hour is how many joules? Means it is 3.6 into 10 to the power 5. Where did this decimal point suddenly come from? You may be wondering. So now, I said you know children, previously while solving the problems and all, see 36 was a whole number, there was no decimal point. But I made it 3.6 and added plus 1 to the power. It was to the power 5 before. Why did we got power 5? 5 zeros were there here. So we wrote 5 to the power 5. Plus 1 I did. If you are writing plus 1, if you are adding plus 1 to the power, means you are shifting the decimal point in the backward direction. Remember this rule. If you are shifting the decimal point in the forward direction, you will minus so many decimal places with the power. Now I am shifting one decimal point. I am making 36 as 3.6. Means one decimal shift point I am shifting backward. But tell me, no number from where did you shift? You may question. If no numbers are there and you are shifting the decimal points, children, it is understood that 0 is there. You will assume that zeros are there. Okay, na? So from that 0, you shifted one decimal point backward. So I added 36 became 3.6. And to the power plus 5, I added plus 1. For 5 plus 1 is 6. 1 kilowatt hour is how many joules? Means 3.6 into 10 to the power 6 joules. That is what is given. So 1 kilowatt hour is 3.6 into 10 power 6 joules. And you have the last two exemplar problems in your textbook, children, which is very easy again. Solution, solve it. First question, exam.